Hi, so this is video number 4 in the series of videos on introduction to basics of balance sheet, and we were discussing about a case called Music Mart, and we have seen about 15 transactions so far now, and after each transaction how does the balance sheet changes, what changes come in the balance sheet, and what are the basic intuitive feelings about this balance sheet that we have been seeing. And so far, after these 15 transactions, we have come up to this situation. And I request you to go through the other 3 videos, and this is the 4th video on the series, and we will continue our discussion on this 4th video. Okay, before we go to the next transaction, let us just take stock of what is the current status of the company. We have just survived a fire incident in the company, and right now our cash account is standing at 49,150, and that's all we have as assets of the company. And on the right side we have series of loans, and from the retained earnings we say that we are running in loss of 3,350. Now the next transaction that comes in this series of transactions is Music Mart was dissolved and declared bankrupt, and company was dissolved, and who made how much profit? This is the question. So before going to that, let us calculate the latest balance sheet of the company. So you can pause and think about the balance sheet. In fact, there's nothing to think about the balance sheet. When the company is dissolved, the entire balance sheet becomes full of zeros. So there is nothing left to calculate in this. Only thing is, we are not worried about how much profit or loss made by the company, because the company doesn't survive no longer. So we are only interested about the owners of the company, what they made and what they got. So there is something called leftover cash which you have to calculate. Let me just go back, and the cash account showed 49,150 earlier, and when we dissolve the company, the loan of the bank will be repaid first, so 12,500 will go, and payables will be repaid, so 5,000 will go, and whatever is remaining, that is open for sharing between the equity shareholders and the capital owners of the company. So we do a small calculation: 49,150 minus this 12,500 and minus 5,000. So that calculation is shown here, and we found that the leftover cash is 31,650. Now, this leftover cash is claimed by the various parties. Basically, right now we have only John and Khan. So let us look at that calculation. So I have made a table here. So out of this table, let's look at discuss the lower part of the table first. So and then we'll go to the above part. So look at this one. Okay, this topic I'll move ahead. So look at this table on your screen now. So there are John and Khan, and as you can recollect from the story that we have been following, John had 450 shares and Khan had 550 shares. So Khan earlier had 100 and they bought back 450 each. So total 1,000 shares are accounted between these two people. So now what was the book value of the share? According to book value, the share book value is 450 into 10 and 550 into 10. So this is the book value of the share under John and Khan. And their initial capital investment was this. So this is also there. And therefore, if I add these two figures, I will be getting 17,000 under the name of John and 18,000 under the name of Khan. So this is the net investment that they are doing to the business. And if I take the ratio 17 is to 18, and that means 17 divided by 17 plus 18, so that will be 0.4857. That means 48.57% of the investment is held by John and 51.4% of the investment is held by Khan on the whole. And as you can recollect, the leftover cash was 31,650. So this leftover cash is shared in this ratio. So 31,650 multiplied by this will give me 15,373, and this multiplied by this 0.5142 will give me 16,277. So finally, from this little table, what we have seen is the profile of the shareholdings and the book value of the share and the profile of the investment holdings, and finally the net investment held by all the parties, John and Khan, and and based on that ratio I am breaking up the whatever leftover cash is there. So this 15373 and 16277 will be the final leftover cash. But John and Khan themselves were doing some business, or they are involved in some transactions above. So let us recollect. I hope you all, since you have been through seeing the other three videos, you remember all this happenings of Jan 1 to Jan 16. So let's look at the cash flows now. Though in the middle column we have the cash flows of John, and the last column the Khan's cash flows are there. It's very easy to understand. On 1st Jan, John personally shelled out $25,000 and gave it to the company to start the business. So therefore John's cash flow is negative $25,000 on 1st Jan. Then nothing much is happening with John, but the company was doing some transactions. But on 7th Jan, if you can remember, John came to the company and took $1,000 of cash from the company. So that has shown as positive cash flow for John. So John received this cash. Similarly, on 8th Jan, John took worth CDs of $750. So even that is a positive cash flow shown under the John's account. And on 9th Jan, it's becoming kind of a tongue twister, Jan and John. So John sold half of his share to Khan, but the share, his share was sold at $15,000. So this is again a positive cash flow under the John's account. And Khan comes into picture now. Khan has spent $15,000 to buy his half of the share of the company. So that you can see it here. And then on 10th Jan, we see that we went public and Khan purchased 100 shares worth $10 each. So now Khan has to again shell out $1,000. So that I've shown as negative under the Khan's account. And in course of time, the business was going on. And on 15th Jan, after the fire incident on 15th Jan, John and Khan bought back their shares. So when they buy back, they have to shell out again money. So 450 shares for $1 each, because the market price of the shares was only $1. So they had lost only 450 each on this buying back of the shares. And in the end, on 16th, when the company was dissolved, this 15373 and 1627 are the money that they both received. The calculation was shown in the below table. So if I add up this entire column, I'll get the net cash flow for John made between 1st Jan and 16th Jan, and the net cash flow for Khan. So Khan lost about $173, and in the process John gained about $6,673. So this is about the entire process of calculating the profit and loss of John and Khan. Now, normally the discussion would end here, but let us be a little more skeptical, a little more doubtful, and look what exactly happened. If you see the final things, there was a bad news and the stock price fell and the owners came and bought back all the shares. So that's what is happening here. There was a bad news on 14th and owners came and bought back their shares on for a very low price. When they are selling the share, they sold at a very high price, $10, and when they are buying back, they are buying it only $1. And there was the reason for that was a bad news. And bad news, as a result, the company made a loss, but not the owners of the company. Of course, at least John did not make a loss. On the whole, John stands at a profit of 6673. So, although the company is at loss, why did John make a profit? And also, if you look at one more thing, just before the day, we have 13th Jan, where there was some repair and maintenance work. And after this repair and maintenance work was done, and the next day there was a fire. So, are these incidents related? Is what kind of maintenance work or what kind of repair was done, so that you know something bad happens and therefore you know the John ends up with a profit in the long term. So this leads to a doubt that was this fire intentional, and did John has to do anything in this? So when you dig deep into this balance sheets and business, you can find some incidents like this or some stories like this. And now if it's currently only a working theory, and if you further investigate and do find some truth that John has a role in this, then that's it. So that's how the big things happen. Okay, I think this is the concluding part of the introduction to balance sheet and final balance sheet. Let me leave it with this, and we'll see in more videos like this.